Abhi Agarwal. If you grew a long beard, you'd definitely be called Abraham Lincoln. Abhi Agarwal, thank you for your comment. I used to get Abraham Lincoln quite a lot. I still do, actually. I've always enjoyed it. So something like this, maybe. I'm going to stay really still and maybe a beard will pop out. So, yeah. What do you think? Does it look good? Do I look like Abraham Lincoln? Welcome to another episode of Responding to Your Comments. My goodness, the weather is amazing, and I thought I'd be efficient and film two episodes of Responding to Your Comments whilst I'm out here in Switzerland. So what are we waiting for? Let's do this. Maria Busuto, I just started watching your videos. How do you know you're lacking vitamin D? Keep them coming, I find them interesting and helpful as I'm a carer and a hoe. Thank you. Maria, thank you for your comment. This brought a smile to my face. I did make a video on vitamin D deficiency a long time ago. So I'll leave a link up here for you. In terms of deficiency, the symptoms are like tiredness, weakness, muscle pains. These are the most common symptoms, but I see so many patients' blood results every day with vitamin D deficiencies. It's very common. I'll also leave a link in the description below because certain people are actually more prone to vitamin D deficiency. They're higher risk of it. So please check it out if anyone is wondering about it. There's loads more information in the description below. Thank you for your comment. William Altizer. Eating earthworms always seems to work for me, or listening to Chinese pop. William, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Get Rid of Hiccups video. Remember that all my remedies are remedies. There's no scientific evidence supporting them, so you can't actually say this is gonna work, it's just a remedy. But I mean, if eating earthworms works for you, then cool. But I wouldn't recommend anyone to do that, so. That's a no from me. And the sun is really coming out now. When I started filming, it was a bit cloudy, so it was good for filming. Now it might not look too good, but let's carry on. Hanif Kamaria. Hi Abraham, it's me again. Just want to add another question. Can you make a video on storage of syrup medicines? Because I see a lot of public like to put all the medicines in the fridge, despite some of it needs to be stored at room temperature. Hanif, this is a great comment slash question. I see it too. I see so many patients. I see actually so many family members that put them in fridges, and I've sort of rectified that now. But in terms of putting medicines in the fridge, if it says it on the label, if it says it on the information leaflet, if it says it on the box to store in the fridge, then store it in the fridge. So it's 2 to 8 degrees it has to be stored in. But all other medication, which doesn't have to be stored in the fridge, is anything under 25 degrees. And you have to store it in a cool, dry place. The problem is that when you put it in a fridge, like tablets and medicines, there's so much humidity in the fridge that it will damage the tablets. So that's the last thing you want to do, because you're going to waste your medicines and they're not going to work properly. So store them in a cool, dry place, preferably a medicines cabinet, and out of sight and reach of children as well. Thank you for your comment. The Banana Duck. Not only is this video helpful, the editing is spot on. The Banana Duck, your comment is spot on. Yeah, I really wish we had more time, because I could and we could do some really weird and wonderful editing techniques as well, but we're really running out of time these days. So thank you for your comment, and we are looking for an editor pretty soon. So if anyone is in the UK and is good at editing videos, drop me a message, drop me a comment, and I'll be in touch. And that's the end of this week's video. I think I blitzed through this week's episode very quickly because I'm quite cold, although the sun is heating me up. Thank you for all the comments again. We're getting over 2,500 comments per month, 1.1 million views per month. It's crazy. It's amazing. Thank you. But if I haven't got back to your comment, leave the number of comment and I'll try my best to get back to you. And don't forget to subscribe and click that bell button so YouTube knows that you're enjoying my videos and you want to see more. Now I'm going to go off snowboarding. I'll see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.